We're here at NeverEndingPanel.com with a spot interview with author, lecturer, and martial and physical artist extraordinaire Steve Barnes. Eitan and I are a bit jealous. Steve's first book was nominated for a Hugo, and it was with author Larry Niven. If you haven't seen his work, you should definitely look him up. I'm more interested in talking to you, Steve, about you have this extraordinary life. You have achieved black belt in many disciplines.
Only three.
Oh, okay.
Only
but
three.
Only three,
okay.
Not to mention mastery of countless more. Lecturer, writer, your story about how you got to basically collaborate with Jerry Purnell and Larry Niven, essentially at that point nobody knew you and these guys were sort of gods of science fiction, talks to a certain tenacity and determination that is pretty amazing. And I understand that you have a website now that essentially talks about sort of arriving, I guess, at your dreams, correct?
Yeah, I think it's exactly that. I think that I realized, especially with the birth of my son, when I took my daughter to Africa with me to research a novel, we got charged by an elephant on the lip of Ngorongoro Crater, and something like that really does bring home the fact that we are mortal.
Yeah.
So when I got back, I wanted to take everything that I'd ever learned about being a human being and put it into one place, so that if she ever wondered who her father was, she could just kind of pop a DVD and take a look at my core philosophy. When I had my son, Jason, I adopted my son Jason, I wanted to do the same thing for him, but my philosophy of life had matured more at that time. So I wanted something so that if he's 15 years old and starts looking out at the world and saying, what is it going to take to become an adult? What does it take to be a man? Or who was my father? And I'm not there. I mean, if something happens to me in the next 12 months...
God forbid.
Absolutely. Your lips to God's ears. I wanted to put it all down. I have been so blessed in the quality of teachers that I've had in many different arenas of my life. And the only way I can repay them for what they gave me is to pay forward, is to teach forward. That's the only thing I can do. So I have the teaching bug in that sense.
It's men like you that remind me just how lazy I truly am.
I just had this compulsion to, I just had this belief that unless I could be extraordinary, I wasn't going to be anything at all.
So where is this website?
It's www.realheroesjourney.com. Or diamondhour.com. So, either one of those.
So if somebody went to this, you know, in other words, what would you, what's, you know, in a nutshell, what is this program?
Aside from all the free articles and the links to interesting resources, what this course is a month-long course. It's a 30-day course, 5 days a week. You are having pretty much a conversation with me in terms of talking about a number of different things that are organized along the structure. First, the 10 steps of the hero's journey, then the 7 steps of the yogic chakras, because the chakras talk about what it is to be a human being, and then the last 3 are discussions of body, mind, and spirit. And then on the weekends, there are visualization exercises that specifically address where in your personality the greatest blocks are. And it's based on a tremendous amount of sort of cross-referencing different models of humanity and different models of personal growth from psychological disciplines and spiritual disciplines. I have studied Ericksonian hypnosis and pan-cultural shamanism and neuro-linguistic programming and martial arts and yoga and this and this and this.
Again, feeling lazy.
And it all dovetails at some point. At some point, you realize that they're all talking about the same thing. And the reason you can't put the secret of life sort of into words is it doesn't fit there any more than you can describe a hamburger enough for it to nourish your body.
Right.
At some point, there's a certain amount of experientialism. So, but I think that there is enough information from enough different cultures now that it's possible to take a look at what have all these different cultures been saying about the nature of reality, about the nature of human maturation, about being an adult, being awake, and being enlightened. You, by the way, you want to know what enlightenment is? I can actually tell you what it is. I'm serious about this.
Go ahead.
Okay.
No, I don't need it.
No. By the way, saying what it is different
and
from
knowing,
having
knowing
it.
I'm smiling at you and saying this while my executive producer is saying, quickly.
Okay. Enlightenment is a state of awareness that ordinarily opens at the moment of death. Only all these different spiritual disciplines try to get that open before you get there.
Ah, that's kind of cool.
It is.
So
it's
the Europeans
very cool.
Basically stole the word.
Cool.
Well, everybody stole the concept from everybody. It doesn't belong to anybody.
Well, I was referring to the European Enlightenment.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
I think that's terrific. A lot of people just arrive at their success because of tenacity, and they get there, and then they get to look backwards. And what you're telling us essentially is, through your obviously great success in writing and as a hypnotherapist and a lecturer, you're sharing it. And please, once again, just say what the website is. We're going to post it on top of the website also.
Yeah. DiamondHour.com or RealHeroesJourney.com. Either one of them will get you there.
Thank you, Steve Barnes, for joining us at NeverEndingPanel.com.
You are so welcome.